Texas. I just add oil and vinegar and, ooh, what a great new lemony taste.
Try new lemon and herbs and new blue cheese and herbs. Two new zesty good ones from Good Seasons.
Hi, I'm Wendy Turnbull, and I'd like to invite you to see the finals of the Virginia Slims of San Diego Tennis Tournament right here on San Diego's KUSI TV 51, your number for great sports.
Greatest American Hero, Sundays at 5 on San Diego's KUSI TV 51. Live from the San Diego Hilton Beach and Tennis Resort, it's the finals of the Virginia Slims of San Diego Tennis Tournament. Today's World Championship Series matches are brought to you by Baskin-Robbins, Coors, Pacific Dotson, J. Roget Champagne, and Continental Airlines.
Resort on San Diego's beautiful Mission Bay. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Don Russell, your commentator for today, and welcome to the $75,000 Virginia Slims of San Diego Tennis Championships. Final round action for you, and to the right, to call the color for you, Andrea Yeager, one of the great young players in the world of ladies professional tennis, and to my left, down on court for the commentary, Valerie Ziegenfuss, a former ladies professional tennis player. Andrea, today we have Wendy Turnbull out of Australia, the number one player here, but the number seventh player in the world. She is going against the young rookie, Annabelle Croft out of Kent, England. $12,000 first place prize, $6,500 second place. Who do you think will win, and what does the action look like today?
Well, Wendy's supposed to win the tournament, and so far she's been keeping up with her seed, and I think she just has more experience than Annabelle. I don't think Annabelle's ever gotten to the final of a Virginia Slims tournament, so she might be a little bit nervous. And also, she's had a lot of, you know, long singles matches. Yesterday she went three sets at night, so she might be a little bit tired. I'll just have to go with Wendy tonight.
Okay, what about the personalities of the players? Wendy's a fast-paced, aggressive style. Annabelle Croft is just now proving herself. Something about them and how they're going to play each other.
Well, it's interesting because Annabelle's been playing on the tour for a long time. It's just now she's finally done really well and people have taken notice. And, you know, Wendy, she's always been in the top 10. I mean, it seems like every time you're looking in the quarters or semis, Wendy's there. And I think Wendy has a lot more experience and she'll try to move Annabelle around and, you know, use more of her mental capabilities than I think Annabelle will. Like, a lot of the younger players, they just rely on what they know and what they have, whereas the older players, they try to outsmart some of the other ones.
So the experience is going to play a major factor.
Yeah, it sure will, because, you know, Wendy's been in so many singles finals that this is probably just an old hat for her.
Okay, and what about the wind today? It's blowing hard. It can affect action on the court. What are they going to do with that?
Well, it's been windy all week, especially in the day matches, so, you know, maybe the players will be used to it. I think if it starts swirling over there, Annabelle's going to have a hard time passing Wendy, because Wendy likes to come in, and, you know, if you have someone on top of the net and it's windy, it's hard to lob.
Okay, well, that's what you can expect today, and we'll be back with the action in this Virginia Slims Championship Final right after this commercial break.
Attention, the Mad Jacks Red Tag Sale is going on now, and it's the largest sale in our history. All seven stores have marked down every receiver, every tape deck, every video recorder, every television, every car stereo, every system, everything and anything in stock, up to 50% off. Now is the time to buy. The Mad Jacks Red Tag Sale must end Tuesday. Take advantage of these prices that are absolutely our lowest. The Mad Jacks Red Tag Sale is going on now at all seven Mad Jacks.
Americans have a peculiar image of the Frenchman, wearing expensive clothes, surrounded by beautiful women, and sipping champagne. Not true, although I must admit I do enjoy my champagne. Thank you. It's J. Roget champagne. It's deliciously crisp, dry, and yet romantically subtle. It fits my simple lifestyle. J. Roget, perfect for a quiet night at home. J. Roget champagne, one of life's simple pleasures.
This is the reason there's only one Coors Brewery in the world. When this snow melts, it'll flow through miles of porous rock and sand. This natural filtration helps create a clarity, a purity that's so remarkable, Coors doesn't have to do a thing to their water. Rocky Mountain Spring Water helps give Coors a difference worth tasting. When you want a beer that's a little less heavy, never bitter, but with all the spirit of a great beer, Coors is the one.
On April 29th, it's a full card of Dynamite Don King Boxing. Vindication Blockbuster in Buffalo, featuring WBA heavyweight champion Greg Bage versus number one WBA contender Tony TNT Tubbs. Also, James Braun versus terrible Tim Witherspoon and Hector Macho Camacho versus Roque Montoya. Plus, first time on free TV, an edited replay of Larry Holmes versus David Bay in exclusive and explosive action Monday night at 7 here on San Diego's KUSI TV 51.
Welcome back, Andrea Yeager and Don Russell here above the tennis action for you. We've got Wendy Turnbull and Annabelle Croft warming up. But before we get into this action, Andrea, we want to take a look back at the quarterfinal rounds and how these players got here. And there was a number of exciting matches for these players to arrive. Hu Na, we see here in the quarterfinal action against Mary Lou Piatek. And then Roz Fairbank going against Annabelle Croft, who has made it this far to the final. Melissa Gurney playing against Beth Herr, and Betsy Nagelson losing her match to Wendy Turnbull, who is our other qualifier. Now, in semifinal round action, we had Annabelle Croft going against Melissa Gurney. We want to take a look at that match for you and show you how Annabelle Croft got into this final round play against the veteran Wendy Turnbull. Here's the final point for the match, and we'll notice Melissa being moved around and hits the ball out, and there it is. Annabelle Croft takes the upset victory, and this young 18-year-old player out of Kent, England, is in the final against the veteran Wendy Turnbull. So exciting action for you today. Andrea, the two players are warming up. What can we expect from Annabelle Croft in the way of being relaxed and in the match right away? Wouldn't she be a little nervous, do you think?
I think so, because, you know, this is a Virginia Slims final, and when you play someone like Wendy, you just have to take a couple games just to get into it. I mean, it is on TV, and, you know, so it is exciting for her. But getting back to the matches played earlier in the tournament, Wendy and Annabelle both went three sets in their first round, which I found interesting because I think that was Wendy's toughest match, and Annabelle had to play her roommate first round. So they both, you know, they've had a lot of matches, and they, you know, they're both used to playing game after game and set after set, so that might help, you know, save Annabelle from having a lot of nerve problems.
Now, I know both players are in excellent condition, obviously, aerobically and physically. So Wendy's had some short matches. Her last match, she won quite handily in 55 minutes to get here, whereas Annabelle Croft had to work a little bit harder. Will that be a factor at all as we start playing?
Well, Wendy also has to play doubles, and whenever Wendy plays at tournaments, she likes to play singles and doubles. So I just, you know, it'll be interesting to see how the match will go, you know, if one player gets more tired than the other.
Okay.
As in the dance, there is art in the performance of all continental people. Art pursued by endless hours of training, years of dedication, a lifetime devoted to the quest of perfection. Performance after performance. And it is this art which we perform for you every time we take the stage.
Back now, we've got the action in game number two. Annabelle Croft serving at one love. Wendy Turnbull's going to have to pull herself back together here and get on track and try to break Annabelle's serve and bring this match back to even in games. Aggressive play by both these ladies. And Annabelle Croft hits that cross-cut forehand just out at love 15 now. Wendy Turnbull would like nothing better, Andrea, than to get right back in this match and break her.
Yeah, she certainly doesn't want to lose this game, too, and go behind 2-0, especially on this side of the court with all the wind.
From the lovely tennis facility here at the Hilton Beach and Resort on Mission Bay in San Diego, the action is furious. And Annabelle Croft gets pulled out of position by Wendy Turnbull's fine cross-court shot. Love 30 to Wendy Turnbull, and a chance here to really put the pressure on her quick.
Yeah, Annabelle might get in trouble if she keeps on running around her backhand, because Wendy might go down the line or, you know, do what she just did there, you know, go for a cross-court angle.
She's going to have to disguise her play a little bit more against this veteran too, isn't she?
Yeah, Wendy's very smart. You can't really put anything by her without her, you know, knowing. I'm sure she knows exactly how to beat Annabelle. It's just a matter of putting it all together.
And there with that forehand into the net, Wendy Turnbull is still ahead. The match is at 15-30 now. Annabelle Croft serving. This young rookie player out of Kent, England, looking to upset the entire field here. The number one player in the world is here, Wendy Turnbull, for this tournament. She's number 7 ranked. Annabelle Croft is ranked 83rd in the world. And hits that out for a 15-40 disadvantage. And at this point, Wendy Turnbull's got to be feeling that things are going her way again, and now just maintain and stay close.
Yeah, she's done well about coming in just on, you know, any kind of shot. Before, in her service game, she didn't serve a volley, and I think that might have been why she lost the game.
Annabelle Croft now, her second service at 15-40. Must get this in, or this game is over in match number, in this match, set number 1. Just out for 30-40, so Wendy Turnbull had a chance there. Now has to play again for that point to win this possible second game for her. Young lady who's won $41,000 this year already on the tennis tour. That shot just in on the baseline, coming to the net. Annabelle Croft spots it nicely and puts her away for the cross-court forehand.
Yeah, with Annabelle's forehand, it is hard to see if she's going to go cross-court or down the line. So sometimes when Wendy comes in, she might have to guess on that shot. Her backhand usually just goes one direction.
So Annabelle has come back here. The match is now at deuce and a chance to take the advantage to possibly win game number 2. Wendy Turnbull has hit the shot too long on the forehand. It's now advantage Annabelle Croft. Now, I wouldn't think that would happen with Wendy Turnbull. I thought she'd keep the ball in play.
That's not really her strategy, to just sit out there. Usually, she'll go for a shot if she thinks she has it. You know,
even if the knee's hitting it out, huh?
Yeah, sometimes. You know, you just have to do that when you're serving volley. You have to take your chances.
Okay. Annabelle Croft now going for this game number 2. That ball was out, and Annabelle Croft has now won the first 2 games in this first set, this championship final. Yeah, Andrea, can you tell us a little bit about the final today and how many sets the players are going to be playing?
Well, for this singles, it's going to be 2 out of 3 sets. Wendy obviously has a doubles right after, so she's going to have a long day.
So it's really important who wins the first set.
It is, because, you know, especially playing in the afternoon with the sun here, you might get hotter, you might get tired. And, you know, by Sunday, you can be tired if you've played a lot of matches.
All right, serving at 2 games to love Wendy Turnbull. She is down and back against the wall right now.
What I think is interesting is, out of all the players here, Wendy has never really traveled with a coach, and Annabelle is here on her own, too. You see a lot of players traveling with coaches or parents. I mean, I came here with my best friend, and, you know, these two are out there just by themselves, and, you know, they're in the finals. I think that's great for someone like Annabelle, who's only 18.
Next service on the first serve, Wendy Turnbull, trying to pull herself back in this match and win game number 3. Trying to get this serve in. And the score now at 15 all. So Annabelle Croft hitting that, again, running around the ball and hitting a down the line forehand. She hits it out.
Yeah, she has to take her chances on those, because some, like in the first game, she made that. And, you know, now that it's 1-1, she still wants to put the pressure on.
That service again on the first serve. So Wendy Turnbull will be serving her first serve over again at 15 all. Now her second service. It's very important to get that second serve in. You don't hit it with as much intensity when you try to place it, right?
But you put a lot more spin on it, especially in this wind. You have to, they're probably going to take some speed off their first serve even and try to put some more spin on so it stays in.
When he comes to the net, excellent cross-court forehand there to take the lead out to 30-15. And now have a chance to put some pressure on Annabelle Croft and take game number three away from her. Annabelle Croft, incidentally, with just under $5,000 in money winnings, really is having a very big day here today, Andrea. If second place is where she finishes, she still makes more than she's made all year, $6,500.
Yeah, I talked to her before the tournament, and, you know, we were just talking about the tournament she's played, and she said that she lost a couple times first round and stuff, and, you know, this is great for her. I mean, she must be really happy about how she's done.
Well, there Annabelle moving Wendy Turnbull around, hits that beautiful cross-court forehand for a winner, and now the match is at 30-all. Again, another first service let. And you'll notice that on the second serve, she's going to put a lot more spin on the ball, like Andrea Yeager has said, and try to place that ball away from Annabelle Croft. That ball is out. Wendy Turnbull quickly finds herself in another disadvantage situation, down 30-40 now, a chance to lose game number three, and this could start to change the complexion of the match if she gets three games down.
I think because of the win, the players are having a hard time holding their serve. It'll be interesting to see, you know, how Annabelle will do, and, you know, after this game.
Out! And a fine drop volley shot by Wendy Turnbull brings the score back to deuce. Now, you said earlier that she was going to do that a lot to Annabelle Croft, try to pull her into the net, push her back, and then hit that drop volley and pull her in, but, you know, keep her off balance.
Yeah, I'm surprised, though, because Wendy usually comes in a little bit more. She seems to be a little bit tentative about whether she should serve a volley or not. I mean, the last point she came in and she won it easily.
Oh.
And this one she won on the second shot. I would think she would come in a little bit more because she's winning so many points faster that way.
Okay, now the advantage to Wendy Turnbull and the chance here to win her first game in this first set. Game number three. So an important point right here. And she really is not getting her first serve in.
Yeah, I don't know whether it's the wind or if she's just taking a while to warm up. And that's why she can't come in, because it's harder to serve and volley on a second serve with, you know, Annabelle's return. She always goes for, you know, try to go for aggressive return.
Excellent lob by Annabelle Croft brings Wendy Turnbull back away from the net. That time it didn't work.
No, it didn't. I think the drop shot was a little high. It's interesting, though, because when you watch from up here, it looks a lot different than it is down there.
And replay, we'll get a chance to look at that one more time.
It looks like the players are, you know, running for the ball so easy and just hitting it, but actually they're going, you know, for a lot of shots, and every shot is hard to hit. I mean, on TV, like, just up here, it looks easy.
And Annabelle Croft has kept Wendy Turnbull off balance on that last point. The advantage now goes to Annabelle Croft. And this young lady looks very cool out there, very calm. Looks like she knows what she has to do, and she's playing her game right now.
Yeah, she is. She wants to keep, you know, Wendy guessing, you know, what's going to happen. Because if Wendy doesn't get in her first serve, you know, she has to stay back. She can't come in on every second serve.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong. It's important to hit that ball on the serve at the top of the arc. Looks like Wendy's waiting to hit it as it's coming down.
Yeah, I thought she was letting it drop before, but that just could be because of the wind. You know, some players, I mean, I've seen players toss the ball 20 feet high, and then, you know, they still let it drop on it.
You stay with us. We'll be back with more of this action in this fine, exciting final round at the Virginia Slims Championships right after this commercial break.
Welcome to Baskin-Robbins, where you can taste the glory of German chocolate cake, the delight of cherries jubilee, the perkiness of Jamocha almond fudge. Whether you're after the ripeness of a very, very strawberry, the freshness of a chocolate mint, or in sherbet, or the indulgence of pralines and cream, whatever you're craving, wear your taste at Baskin-Robbins.
This week at Sun Valley Waterbeds have we got plans for you. We're 45 showrooms strong, which means our nationwide buying power saves you money with low monthly payments. For less than $46 per month, you can have this beautiful mirrored bookcase waterbed, solid wood triple dresser, attractive hutch, and two-drawer nightstand, a complete bedroom for less than $46 per month. So this week, plan on extra savings and plan on low monthly payments at Sun Valley Waterbed. You'll sleep better.
When you buy one of these, get ready for a lot of questions.
Is it really an 86?
Yep.
Is it really completely re-engineered?
Yep.
Does it really come with a 5-speed radio, spoker wheels, a rear step bumper, and sporty stripe standard?
Yep.
Is it really only $63.95?
Yep.
Is it really a sporty truck priced close to Toyota's and Nissan's base trucks?
Yep.
Have you heard the weather forecast?
Nope. Get a lot of value at your San Diego
County Monster Man. Back now for the action in this Virginia Slims of San Diego Championship Final. Annabelle Croft has taken a big lead in match number in this first set, 3-0, and she's broken Wendy Turnbull twice already, Andrea Yeager. So what are you going to look for Andrea, for Wendy Turnbull to be different now?
Well, Wendy had so many chances in all the games. I mean, she had chances to break Annabelle back, and you know, and she had chances on her serve. It's just she's not finishing the games. And you know, she's now I think she's just going to go for a lot more. She might even make more mistakes.
She'll pull out all the stops. And there, a powerful down-the-line forehand puts Annabelle Croft out of position. And the first point to Wendy Turnbull, love 15 at this point. But Annabelle Croft working on a 3-0 lead. I notice Annabelle's getting her first service in, whereas Wendy has not. That's got to change a little bit for Wendy if she's going to stay aggressive.
Yeah, because she wants to come into the net. I mean, she had chances on her serve, and you know, and then she just lost it because she didn't get in a lot of first serves.
Right. Okay. And that ball hit out. So love 30 now for Wendy Turnbull. Last time she had Annabelle Croft in this position at 15-40, and Annabelle Croft came back. So it doesn't necessarily mean how you're down, it's how you come back sometimes.
Yeah, I think Wendy's not concentrating as hard as she usually does, because you know when she's up 15-40 or 30 love, she usually doesn't win the game.
And Annabelle Croft just hit a powerful first service in the center of the court, caught Wendy Turnbull off guard. Score now 15-30, a chance here to even that deuce. And there, that shot out by Wendy Turnbull, 30 all, we're at deuce. And Wendy Turnbull, you're right, I think she's not concentrating right now. She looks a little too relaxed.
Yeah, I don't know what it is. She might be a little tired also. But, it, you know, that first game was really a long one for her on her serve, and then that might have done it.
And there, 40-30 now, Annabelle Croft has taken the advantage of this match, has a chance to win game number four, and just about put this set away. Do you think it's possible that Wendy Turnbull has taken Annabelle Croft a little too lightly?
I don't know. I don't think Wendy really takes anyone lightly. She just goes out there and she plays her normal game. But, you know, this to me is a little surprising because normally she comes in and she's more aggressive and, you know, she looks like she's into the match. Here, you know, I remember she lost one game and she pretended to hit a ball between her legs and another one lefty. And she just doesn't seem to be the same Wendy that she was earlier in the tournament.
Okay, and then Annabelle Croft looking very much like she wants to look as a champion. She is ahead 4-0 in this first set, and a very important first set. We are going to play 2 out of 3 here, so whoever gets off to a quick start could really take this match in control. And Wendy Turnbull looking tired, not getting her first service in. That allows Annabelle Croft to come in on that second serve and really put it away. She doesn't even have to do that this time. It's a double fault.
Yeah, I think Wendy's going to have to try to get back into this set if she wants to get back in the match. Because if she doesn't start now and she starts maybe in the second set, she'll run into a few problems.
Love 15. They're now 15 all. So Wendy Turnbull trying to gather herself, I'm sure, mentally, just coercing herself to get back in this match, get her energy level up, get aggressive, start coming to that net, start putting the pressure on Annabelle Croft. She's always been known for her speed, Wendy Turnbull has. Now she has to start getting the wheels turned up to high gear, huh? And there Annabelle Croft just catches her out of position with a beautiful down-the-line forehand. So she's mixing up. She's going down the line, cross-court. She's trying to keep Wendy as much off balance as Wendy would like to keep her.
Yeah, I think on a second serve, you know, Annabelle started at the beginning of the match going for the returns. And, you know, that's helped her because she's made 2 out of 3.
And here at 30-all, Annabelle Croft just made a serious mental mistake there, hitting the ball back into the net on what appeared to be a fairly easy serve to return. So 30-all, a chance here for Wendy Turnbull to go 40-30. Just out. Back down the line, backhand.
Wendy seems to be rushing a lot of stuff. I mean, she goes for her serves, and you know, normally they go in, or she can get some second serves in, and you know, she's just trying to get the point over, it seems like, in 1 or 2 shots.
Okay, Wendy now at 30-40. If she loses this point here, she loses game number 5 and is in jeopardy of losing the first set. Annabelle moving very nicely and has taken game number 5 very convincingly from Wendy Turnbull. Moved nicely to court, hit her backhand and forehand with a lot of spirit.
Yeah, I think Wendy is surprised, along with probably a lot of other people out here. Annabelle's been playing really well all week, but nobody thought she'd take such a commanding lead right away.
Okay, we'll be back with game number 6, set number 1, right after this commercial break.
There's no shortage of import cars at Pacific Datsun. I'm Jerry Dineen, General Manager of Pacific Datsun, to tell you that Pacific has a very large supply of 82 and 83 Sentras, all specially priced and all in excellent condition. We have 2 doors, 4 doors, wagons, automatics, and standard transmissions, and a variety of colors. I suggest you act quickly. Why? Because they are all available with absolutely nothing down and payments of as little as $149 a month. Only while they last and only at Pacific Datsun.
Jerome's TV ad implies that the Brick is selling this 6-piece set for $10.94. Now, that's not true. At the Brick, it's only $6.21, $100 less than Jerome's. Jerome's TV ad implies that the Brick is selling this 6-piece set for $10.94. Now, that's not true. At the Brick, it's only $5.68, $100 less than Jerome's. Every time Jerome's lowers their prices to try to compete with the Brick, we lower our prices even further. Nobody beats the Brick.
As in the dance, there is art in the performance of all continental people. Art pursued by endless hours of training, years of dedication, a lifetime devoted to the quest of perfection. Performance after performance. And it is this art which we perform for you every time we take the stage.
Back now, and we are here for the 6th game in this first set. Wendy Turnbull and Annabelle Croft, the principals. And Annabelle Croft has completely dominated this first set in this Virginia Slims final. She has really taken it to Wendy, and Wendy has not responded, Andrea.
Yeah, I think Annabelle's made some good shots, but a lot of it has to do with Wendy's performance. She's not playing the way she normally does, coming in and, you know, being real confident about her game.
So Wendy's got to pick up the energy level. She has moved quicker and faster on the court this time and takes that point away. So she's got to, like you said, set the standard for herself for the second set right here. Get back in this set, maybe win a game or two and get the momentum going, right?
Yeah, because that will start to worry Annabelle, too. If she just starts in the second set, that might be too late. She might not be getting her serves in or get any rhythm going.
And a fine serve there on the first service by Annabelle Croft to bring this match back to 15-all. Annabelle, to me, does not look nervous. Now, I know she's been a winner before. She's been on the Whitman Cut team. She's played against all the world-class players like yourself. Even though she's very young, she's experienced.
Yeah, she is experienced. Nothing really phases her, and you know, she also has nothing to lose. I mean, if she was ranked maybe 10 or 12, maybe it'd be a little bit of a different story, but nobody expects her to be in the finals. No one expects her to win.
So whatever she does is good.
Yeah.
30-15 now, the score. She is doing very well. Ahead 5-0, and Wendy Turnbull, a powerful down-the-line forehand, and we're at 30-all. Now, that's the Wendy Turnbull we're used to seeing, right? Let's take a look at that very quickly for you, this beautiful down-the-line forehand.
That was a good forehand by Wendy. I think she's going to have to start doing that a little bit more to get back into this.
Okay, at 30 all, Annabelle Croft. Excellent first service percentage so far. Wendy Turnbull just not looking like herself most of the time. Every once in a while we see the powerful aggressive style come out, but she looks slow. She's hitting on the ball late.
Yeah, it could be the wind, but also Wendy hasn't really played a player like Annabelle. She's played Betsy Nagelson in the last match, who, you know, served and volleyed, and she's played some other players.
And there
like
it is, Piatek. The game and first set match. The first set, now it's Annabelle Croft. She won it 6-love. And we're going to come back for match number two, or set number two, excuse me, game number one. And Wendy Turnbull is going to have to start this match out. And what has she got to be thinking right now, Andrea? She just lost 6-0.
I think she should just try to get some more first serves in, and that'll help her a lot in her serve. Annabelle, of course, is hitting some great shots, and Wendy's going for some that's not very high percentage, but she just has to stay in there and not give up.
And that was an excellent down-the-line backhand return to caught Wendy off guard. I don't think she expected that.
No, I don't think so. Like I said before, she hasn't played a player like Annabelle. Annabelle can mix coming in. She's got a one-handed backhand. You know, she can do a lot of different things, whereas, you know, Wendy might not expect that.
Annabelle's aggressive. She's charging. She's hitting her backhand and forehands very powerfully. Just missed the outer line with that point. She is now tied the match 15-all. Wendy Turnbull trying to pull herself back together here and win this second set. First serve there.
Like that one, she took off a lot of the speed and she's already trying to spin it in.
There again, she took off a lot of speed, spun it in, and Annabelle Croft made a nice return, but Wendy caught the net, so that serve will go over. Wendy has to establish herself right now, though, this set.
I think so. She never gives up anyway, so I don't think that'll be a problem. She just has to try to get some shots together that Annabelle can't do anything with.
And she goes to the net and hits cross-court overhead that forces Annabelle out of position. She hits it out, and the point to Wendy Turnbull, 30-15 now. A chance to win this game number one and change the momentum right now at all with Annabelle Croft, this fine young lady professional out of Farnborough, Kent in England. Ooh, excellent off-speed. But Annabelle Croft wasn't fooled, and she takes the point away.
She was right on top of that one, and I don't think Wendy expected that. She thought maybe she'd go down the line. And, you know, Annabelle, that's what the kind of shot she needs. It's harder with a two-hander, but with a one-hander like she has, she has a great chance to hit it in the ankle.
We talk about the speed of Wendy Turnbull, but that Annabelle Croft is not slow out there.
No, she's not at all. There's a lot of players out there who are fast. They just don't get as much recognition as some other players.
Wendy Turnbull received the name The Rabbit when she first joined the tour because of that great speed she employs. And there forces Annabelle into an error, 40-30 to score. And Wendy Turnbull has a chance to take game number one here. So Wendy Turnbull now trying to pull herself together and win game number one, set number two. There it is. She puts a overhead forehand away, and Wendy Turnbull bows to the court and to Annabelle Croft. She has taken finally a game here in the second set. Took one whole set to do that, but she's back on track, and I think that may have loosened her up and helped her a lot, Andrea.
That did help Wendy a lot because she'll have to come out here now and, you know, start the second set like she didn't even play the first set.
Which, and we see replay that final shot. Wendy Turnbull was perfectly positioned, an excellent overhead forehand. She knew right where she wanted to hit it. She saw Annabelle going away from the shot. That's not a tough shot for players like yourself, is it?
I don't know. A lot of people think that it looks easy to us, or it is easy, but it's not, because, you know, Annabelle, I think, is starting to cover her backhand more, because that's where Wendy's winning all the points. And if you see someone moving, you know, that can just throw you off for a second. And in this wind, it's not easy to hit winners.
Yeah, a moment ago, you had a chance to look at the fine crowd that's gathered here. What a beautiful day in San Diego, right on the bank of Mission Bay, the Hilton Beach and Tennis Resort. Lovely spot for the Virginia Slims Championship final match here. We have Annabelle Croft stepping up now, coming out onto the court, and Wendy Turnbull out of Australia, the veteran player. It's time for her to get going. She's going to have to break Annabelle's serve, I think.
Yeah, I think Annabelle might be a little nervous in this game because she knows Wendy's just started, and know, she'll have to come up with some shots again just to stay in here. She's not going to win the match just like that.
Okay, and first service beautifully done by Annabelle Cross. She caught Wendley completely off guard, maybe not even concentrating quite yet. She didn't look like she even had a swing at it.
No, that serve was a really good serve, and I think maybe she was expecting her to go wide.
15 love. Annabelle Cross. Okay, and the pleasure is ours to have a young lady, Valerie Ziegenfuss, with us. Former ladies tennis professional on the tour, now retired and teaching tennis here in San Diego. She is down on the court. We'd like to get some of her observations. Valerie, are you there?
Yes, I am, Don. How are you?
Doing just great. Nice to have you with us.
Yes, it's good to be here. It's a beautiful day.
Question for you, Valerie. We've got two players going at it, and it seems like right now the rookie with less experience is taking over and controlling this match.
The determination on this girl's face is just amazing. She is out here to win. She's not out here just to show up and make a nice match of it. And on the other side, Wendy looks like she's just defending. She's a little scared out here.
She doesn't look aggressive. She doesn't look like her quick-paced self out there.
No, and you can't blame her. She comes in as number 10 in the world and not much to gain this week. But
she isn't really bringing the action to Annabelle Croft. Croft has taken it to her.
That's true. About 2 points a game, I see Wendy be aggressive and go for it. And then she slacks off. So I think she's having trouble concentrating today.
So what's Wendy going to have to do right here to get back at it?
Well, it's very obvious Annabelle's backhand isn't what it is on the forehand side, and Wendy's just not attacking the backhand enough.
So Wendy should play more to the backhand as she has done right there on those 2 points and put that point away.
Yeah.
All right. Good point from Valerie Ziegenfuss. Nice to have you down there. We're going to come back to you periodically for your reactions to what's going on. Thank you, Valerie.
Thank you.
Okay, Andrea Jaeger. Now Wendy is playing to her backhand, Annabelle Croft's backhand. Do you think that's what she has to do as well?
Yeah, I think she'll be going to a backhand in the backhand court all the time on the serve, because I don't think Annabelle's made one return on that side in the last 4 or 5 returns. And, you know, she just has to mix it up. She knows Annabelle can go anywhere with the forehand. She just has to mix it up and, you know, try to different things, not just stay out there and give the match to Annabelle.
Okay. The match is tied in this set at 1 game apiece, 30 love. In this third game, Wendy Turnbull serving.
I also think Wendy's going to start coming in a lot more on Annabelle's backhand. Annabelle seems to have problems passing. She doesn't know whether to go, you know, hit topspin or hit underspin. And that's where Wendy's won a lot of her last points. And, you know, the game that she won and the game that she's now up 30 love.
All right, Wendy Turnbull now. And I really truly believe she has to go get more of those first serves in. Annabelle seems to be jumping on that second serve and putting Wendy out of position.
Right. She always takes offensive whenever Wendy hits the second serve. And that has to, you know, bother Wendy a little bit, because she's the person who's supposed to be hitting the first serves and charging in and putting the volleys away.
Okay. So very important play here by Wendy Turnbull. Game number 3, set number 2. That ball was just long on the serve. So, again, Annabelle Croft gets a chance to attack that second service of Wendy Turnbull's, which is not very powerful. A lot of spin, but Annabelle seems to be handling the spin quite well. And again, a double fault now, out long again. Wendy Turnbull just does not seem to be very consistent.
No, she doesn't. She just seems to be a little erratic, and she doesn't really look like she has much confidence either. Like, things don't bother her. And, you know, normally she comes out here and she's, you know, she's pretty mellow. She doesn't question calls the way she thinks she's sure. She doesn't, you know, yell or scream, but she just doesn't seem to be holding her head as high as she usually does.
And now with the advantage of 40-30, Wendy Turnbull is going to try to put away game number 3 here and take the early lead in this second set. And a fine service that pulled Annabelle Croft off balance. And the game to Wendy Turnbull, the second game, 2-1 now. And Wendy Turnbull sits down for a little bit of a rest, and she has the lead. Well, maybe that's the little bit of an advantage that she needed right now, Andrea.
Yeah, I think she's getting back into the match, and Annabelle knows that. And, you know, it's great because I think the crowd, we have a great crowd here today. And,
yes,
you know,
we do.
It's neat because, you know, we're playing here at the Hilton Hotel, and, you know, the people staying at the Hilton haven't been able to use the courts at all. And it was funny because yesterday I was out there practicing, and I saw Barry Gordy, and he was out there hitting with Mark McCormick, and it was like, you know, they played the Pro-Am, and they could just come out here with any of us.
And he's courtside with us today, watching the action.
I think that's great that there's other people from different walks of life coming out to watch tennis matches, not just tennis players themselves.
And you saw the score superimposed there for a moment. 6-love, the first set to Annabelle Croft. 2-1 in the second set. Wendy Turnbull out of Australia against this fine young player from Kent, England. And a little bit about these players. We haven't had a chance to talk too much, but Wendy Turnbull, obviously the veteran, she's been around for 10 years as a world-class performer. She's won hundreds of thousands of dollars, really up into the millions now. And a player who has proven herself on all kinds of surfaces all around the world, right?
Yeah, she has. She goes out there and she'll go and play, even though she's a serve and volleyer, which you have to give a lot of credit to. And she'll go out there and play singles and play doubles. And, you know, she's great to watch in doubles because she's won the mixed open. And she's won the mixed at, like, say, the U.S. Open. She's won Wimbledon, you know, 2 years running with John Lloyd. So, I mean, she's just an all-around player. It's nice to see that, not just, you know, maybe just a baseline.
Which is one of the reasons why she's in the top 10. All top 10 players like yourself are all-around players. You can play on any surface, really.
We'll just stick with her playing on the surfaces, not me.
All right, and the score, as we see Annabelle Cross serving in game number 4 of the second set, 15-love. Second serve now. And Wendy Turnbull, a little more aggressive on that shot, pulls Annabelle Croft out of position, forces the backhand into the net. We are at 15-all in this fourth game. Now, Annabelle Croft, on the other hand, she's young. She's been around for 2 years. She's won some titles. She's won some money. But she's trying to get her feet on the ground and learn how to play all around the world and on all different surfaces, right?
Yeah, I think so. She practices a lot in England on the grass, so obviously she has a good grass court game.
That's going to help her for Wimbledon.
Yeah, it sure will. She did well 1 year at Wimbledon, and now, you know, hard court probably isn't one of her stronger surfaces because there's a lot of slow hard courts. Luckily for her, this one's a little bit faster.
And there with the double fault, Annabelle Croft puts herself down at 15-30. And another first service not in.
The first point she had an ace, and since then she hasn't gotten a first serve in.
Yes. Annabelle Croft's first serve capability changing dramatically here. And Wendy Turnbull, a little too much power, a down-the-line forehand that, well, she's an aggressive player, and certainly at times she's going to knock a lot of them out.
Yeah. That's, you know, maybe she should just try to get some balls in the court because Annabelle looks like she's getting a little bit, you know, shaky. She doesn't look as confident as the other games. I think that's because Wendy's come back and won 2 games.
Okay. Excellent position by Wendy Turnbull with that down-the-line forehand, pulling Annabelle Croft out of the court and then coming back with a real easy tap shot over to the left side of the court to take the point.
Yeah, Annabelle's, she's hitting her forehand and her serve may be the same, but her backhand seems to be a little bit tentative, and Wendy's taking advantage of that, and that's how she's won her last 2 games and, you know, gotten a break point here.
So what Valerie and you said she had to do is basically what she's doing right now. She's going to Annabelle's backhand.
Yeah, she is, but, you know, also that might be hard, you know, later on, because as soon as the score gets, you know, like maybe 4-1, if it goes 4-1 to Wendy, Annabelle will start hitting out again, you know, so it's just, you know, this game is really important for Annabelle, this one and the next one, because, you know, then she'll get, you know, out of all the nervousness of the second set.
And tried to take a lot off that shot, did Annabelle, from a long way back in the court and just didn't get over the net. So the advantage now to Wendy Turnbull, a chance to take a 3-1 lead in this set, and that certainly will change things. The first time that Annabelle Croft can be broken is right here. Both players staying back at the baseline and exchanging blows, and Annabelle Croft gets the best of that shot, and we are back to deuce.
Her forehand's really been a big factor here. I mean, you can see here, she's just trying to keep her backhand in the court and get it back to Wendy, and as soon as she gets a short one, she tries to go cross-court for the winner and try to keep Wendy off guard.
Okay, for the advantage, Annabelle Croft and missing the first service again. And fine play by Annabelle Croft, again pulling Wendy Turnbull out of position with that first, that second serve, and then down the line forehand to take the point and take the advantage in this game, number 4. And an important one, as you said, if she wins the game, pulls it back to even.
Yeah.
Now, you've spent some time with Annabelle Croft. You said you stayed a little bit at her house in England. What's this lady like?
She's really nice. I spent, like 2 years ago when I was at Wimbledon, I spent some time with her there, and I stayed at her house. And, you know, she's got really nice parents and a sister and a brother. And, you know, I talked with her here for a while, and she's very smart. I mean, I think a lot of people think the younger players who don't go to high school, you know, normally just, you know, don't have, you know, any brains or anything. And she's very educated. I was surprised. I mean, I didn't know, you know, what she was like mentally, but she's very smart.
Annabelle Croft hits that ball wide for the advantage to Wendy Turnbull in this game. So she had the advantage, went back to deuce, now back. Turnbull has the advantage. And an important point here, if Turnbull wants to pull this match to even at two games apiece, but for Annabelle, a chance to...
That's a great serve.
Excellent serve by Annabelle Croft. She seems to mix the same type of game, power and speed together. Has a little few weaker points maybe with her backhand than you see in Wendy Turnbull, but she is a good player, and I think the one thing I like about her is that she keeps Wendy playing her game right now.
Yeah, she's doing well with both things, you know, coming in, staying back, mixing up the pace, and, you know, Wendy hasn't really figured out what she should do exactly.
But a real mental error there by Wendy Turnbull on that forehand into the net. The advantage now to Croft and a chance to take this game and go out to a 3-1 lead in the second set, and really might tell the story, this game right here. $12,000 first place to the winning lady, $6,500 to second place. But a coveted Virginia Slims title. How many points on the tour go to a Virginia Slims title?
Well, it all depends on the prize money of the tournament and where it is. Because, like, right now there was a tournament in Orlando, and that was a much bigger purse, so you get more points there. So this one is a lower tournament, $75,000, so you don't get quite as many points as, you know, a bigger tournament.
Now, Annabelle Croft has pulled this match back to 2 games apiece, so she now has the momentum going for her here in the second set. Wendy Turnbull for a brief moment as we look at playback.
That was a good game for Annabelle because she had to come back from 2 break points, and she hung in there. So, that must give her confidence for this game and for her next service game.
Excellent first service by Wendy Turnbull to get the score at 15-love. I think Wendy Turnbull has to turn up the energy. She's got to get going here.
Yeah, it surprised me because that was a great first serve, and she still stayed at the baseline. So maybe she's just a little tired from playing all the matches, or, you know, maybe she's just taking it easy and waiting for Annabelle to get tired.
Does a player like Wendy, who doesn't know Annabelle that well, possibly figure out a game plan that isn't suited to the player? And when she's playing, she figures it out. As we see the score go to 15-all, she may be figuring out that she has thought wrong about Annabelle's game.
I don't think that's a problem with Wendy. I mean, she knows all the players. She's been on the tour for so long. And I just think the thing is, if you go out there and you're concentrating well, another person's playing well, what can you do? You know,
right.
There's going to be times that you're not playing, you know, at your top level. Another person's playing well. That's where you get upsets.
And Wendy Turnbull hits that forehand long and out, and the score is at 15-30 in a very difficult position for this young lady as she finds herself down at game number 5, a pivotal game. If she loses it, she goes behind in the match 3-2. Annabelle Croft with that cross-court backhand just out, and the score now at 30-all. I wanted to ask you about your own career. You're back into tennis now. You took about 6 months off to go to school and get educated. You said you had a great time, but you're back on the tour. What are your plans in the near future, and how long do you think it's going to take you to get back up to that status that you once enjoyed, number 3 player in the world?
Well, I was hoping to play European clay in the grass court tournaments in Europe, and, you know, I just have to wait and see how my shoulder and how my back and how everything goes. Here it was a little tight and a little sore, so, you know, hopefully I'll be a little bit better when I get home and get some treatment and go over to Europe. I'm really excited about being back because, you know, once you're away from something, you really know that you missed it and that you enjoyed it, and you just want to get back into a competitive atmosphere.
And Wendy Turnbull with that overhand smash puts it away. We're at deuce, and let's see that again in replay.
I think every single ball that Wendy's gotten to her forehand side, she's gone cross court, and that time Annabelle actually ran over there. So you might see Wendy mixing it up a little bit.
Well, we're happy to have you back, Andrew Yeager. I told you once before that right from your young teenage years, you were one of my favorites, and it's nice to see you back. I think that you'll probably find yourself returning to the even better form than ever. We wish you good luck.
Thanks a lot.
Okay. Annabelle Croft now taking the action to Wendy Turnbull.
There's Annabelle's forehand again.
Advantage now to Croft.
Wendy's first serve was in, but Animal's forehand is much stronger than her backhand, and she can hit it both sides.
Look at her aggressively move to the net. She just decided, I'm going to go up there and put that ball away, and she did, and Wendy had nothing to do with it.
And there goes Animal's skirt, flying just as much as her forehand.
Yeah, she's really having to deal with the wind out there with that skirt.
Double fault for Wendy.
And now, a difficult situation for Wendy Turnbull. This lady is down by 3-2 to this young rookie out of Kent, England. One set already played, so the next two games are going to be the very important ones. Annabelle Croft has got to regather herself and stay in there and stay on top of it, whereas Wendy Turnbull has to sincerely come back.
Yeah, Wendy, you know, she's been trying different things. She's tried to come in and she's tried to stay back, but she still looks a little tentative, like she's not sure what's happening, or maybe she's just a little tired, whereas Annabelle is just on the top of her game. I mean, you can't take anything away from Annabelle. She's been, you know, coming up with some great serves. You know, she's hitting a few aces. She's, you know, hit her forehand in every direction. So
it tells you, you don't have to be older or more experienced. You have to be ready to play.
Yeah, that's, you know, especially now. I mean, these days there's a lot of young players coming up, but, you know, later on you're just going to find out whoever walks on the court and plays well and stays in the match mentally is going to do well. You know, it doesn't matter if you've been out there, you know, for a long time or not. It's the younger players, they go out there and they don't care if you're 30 or if you're 15. They just go out there to play and to win and to do the best they can.
As you look around this beautiful facility, you can see Mission Bay in the background, the palm trees. And what a setting it is for not only tennis, but just for being here.
Yeah.
Nice place to be, isn't it, Andrea?
It's great, because last year I heard that the Virginia Slims tournament was only a $50,000 tournament, and now they've gotten more sponsors. You know, Roger Champagne has come in, and you know, a lot of other sponsors, so now it's at just $75,000 and a great resort.
We thank those fine folks, and now Annabelle Croft back in the action, game number 6. She's ahead 3-2, serving for a clear lead, and has the lead at 15-love in this game. Now, she goes ahead 4-2. She just simply has to play her game and relax and stay in the match, right?
Well, when you're down a set in 4-2, you just, you know, you really have nothing to lose. I think Wendy's going like that. I mean, her return, she belted it 100 miles an hour. I think that she's just going to start going for shots.
Just let out all the stops.
Forget it. Yeah.
It's time to play now. My back's against the wall. I have to make good shots. Let's just do it. Okay, Annabelle Croft. Wendy Turnbull now moving around, but that shot, the forehand wide and out. 30-15, Annabelle Croft simply making the better shots all day today, keeping Wendy Turnbull off balance, forcing the issue, really. I would have thought that Annabelle might be a little careful at first, but she's attacked right from the beginning.
Yeah, she has nothing to lose, so I think that's a, you know, that's a big thing for a player that's come in here, because you're doing well. And I've seen players come into a final and say, well, I've gotten to the finals, it's over. But like Vale said before, you know, Annabelle's come out here with the determination to win the match, not just show up and say, hey, you know, I've had a great week, but, you know, that's it.
Wendy Turnbull hits that shot out at 40-15, now in big trouble. Okay, and we've got our courtside commentator for you, Valerie Ziegenfuss, waiting. Valerie, the score's at 40-15. The games are 3-2. Annabelle Croft looks simply unbeatable right now.
Well, I don't think Wendy's out of this if she can pull her game together. She just gave Annabelle that game when it was 2-2. She served 3 double faults and just gave it to her. But if she can put some pressure on Annabelle, it'll be interesting to see if Croft can actually win the tournament. It's very difficult when you get right down to closing out a tournament.
Take a look at this in replay.
That's a very good point that Vale just made, because, you know, doing well and winning a match is totally a different story. And, you know, I thought maybe Annabelle would be nervous at the beginning of the first and the second set, and she hasn't with that. And she's finished her matches, so it'll be interesting to see if she can do it here.
Okay. And in the net with that backhand. The score at deuce. Valerie, again, to me, I'm watching Wendy from up here, but you're a little closer to the action. She looks tentative. She looks a little, maybe not tired, but lackadaisical.
I really wonder what her mental approach was coming into this match, whether she gave it a lot of thought or was overconfident. And I don't think she thought she was going to have as tough a match as Annabelle is giving her. And now it's almost too late. It's like a bad day at the office.
And now the advantage is 2-Croft, a chance to go ahead 4-2. The young lady clearly in control at this point. Wendy Turnbull there puts a powerful overhead forehand away.
Yeah.
We're at deuce.
This is a big game because Annabelle was up 40-15, and here on this point she had another ad, and Wendy here again goes with a forehand cross-court winner.
Okay, Annabelle cross serving at deuce.
She's really been hitting her forehand well. She's been, you know, hitting it down the line and cross court. So Wendy, you know, once she gets there, she doesn't really have much of a shot to hit.
Okay, Annabelle Croft now. Advantage to her. A chance to win this fifth game and go ahead 4-2. And after an excellent first serve, puts that backhand into the net. So we're at deuce again. And Wendy Turnbull simply just trying to stay in this match. Valerie, taking a look at Wendy Turnbull and Annabelle as you watch them play, and you know both these players, I'm sure you know Wendy very well. What do you look for Wendy to do right now?
I look Wendy to stay back a little more and just try and get the ball in play and let Annabelle make some mistakes.
So play the baseline and let Annabelle hit some balls out, right?
Correct.
Okay, let's see what happens here.
Annabelle's being awfully tentative on her back, and I think Wendy's just going to start hitting everything over there.
Certainly, Wendy's got to do something different and get Annabelle off guard, off balance. She looks like she has the control still. There again.
Great shot.
Hit it to her backhand, but Annabelle put it right back on her.
Once she hits topspin on her backhand, she's fine. But if she starts hitting a little bit of underspin, she gets tentative, and usually it doesn't even, you know, go over. It just hits the top of the net.
Okay, we are at deuce, and a chance here for Annabelle to take the advantage. Game number six, set number two. And Wendy Turnbull takes a lot of speed off, but Annabelle Croft gets there. And what excitement that Wendy Turnbull just provided for us there. That's the kind of play that we were looking for right from the beginning. Let's look at that in replay again and notice how Wendy Turnbull moves around Annabelle Croft.
Yeah, she got that one, but she couldn't quite get it in the court.
Now she took a little bit off the second one, put a lot more on the third one, and that kept Annabelle out of play.
Wendy's starting to come up, you know, with some good shots, but you know, she has to put together a game. She can't just, you know, say, okay, well, I played 2 points, you know, the game's over. I think a lot of us do that.
But Wendy Turnbull now, waiting to accept service at deuce.
And Wendy Turnbull.
Annabelle Croft, after that last forehand in the net, hit her racket against the court and said, come on now, let's get back together here. We keep having a chance to put this thing away, and now it's advantage Turnbull. Good concentration by this young lady. She took a little extra time there, pulled herself together.
Watch it, she'll probably do a fall. No.
Double fault she does. I hope you're not becoming a prophet. So now the games are at 3 apiece. Wendy Turnbull has come back strong. Now there was a real chance for Annabelle Croft to not only put Wendy away this set, but put a lot of pressure on Wendy, maybe force her out of her own game plan.
Yeah, Wendy had nothing to lose that game. She was down, you know, 40-15, and she came up with some good shots. And, you know, Annabelle just started getting a little nervous, saying, well, I could go up 4-2. And, you know, that gave Wendy a little chance to come back in the match.
Okay, Wendy Turnbull serving now in game number 7, second set, and a nice first service for the winner. And Annabelle Croft just couldn't get it back. So we're at 15 love. And Wendy Turnbull starting to look like she's getting more aggressive, more energy. And a fine shot by Wendy Turnbull to put the second point away. 30 love now, and a chance to take the lead in this set, 4-3. First serve again for Wendy Turnbull. That was a left. 40-30. Now 30-15, there I saw Wendy. She seemed like she moved the ball sooner than she should. She reacted a little too soon.
Yeah, she's trying to go for some shots and, you know, just get the angle in there. But I think both players are playing just a little bit tentative though.
Part of tennis at this level is certainly anticipation. You have to know or think you know where the ball's going to go and how it's going to get there so you can position for it mentally, right?
Especially in the wind. I think in the wind you have to move your feet probably three times as much than if it's normal conditions. I mean, it's a lot windier down there than, you know, the people can see on TV or the people watching can see.
Good point. Wendy Turnbull answered the call there, came to the net strong and put the shot away to the backhand side of Annabelle Crawford. She couldn't handle it. We're at 40-30, and a chance for Wendy Turnbull to win game number 7 in match set number 2. And Wendy Turnbull has taken game number 7. That puts her ahead of this match 4-3 in the second set. She is still down a set, but with this possible set victory, Wendy Turnbull will be playing for the title with one set. That's all. Comes down to that, doesn't it, Anthea?
Yeah, those were some big points at 40-15 for Annabelle. I think she lost a little bit confidence in herself. She got disappointed, maybe even a little bit mad. And, you know, now she has to come back. And instead of going up, you know, a break, she has to just hold just to stay even.
Okay, and as we get ready for game number 8, I want to go down to Valerie Ziegenfuss. Valerie, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Now, Wendy Turnbull looked very good, especially on the key points at the end of that game to take the advantage in the second set. What do you think she has to do to continue? Stay back, like you said, and just keep putting Annabelle out of position?
I think so. She has to keep the ball in play and wait for Annabelle to overhit. She's been giving a lot of points to Annabelle easy, and as we said, this girl is very determined, and she'll take all those gifts she can. Well, so now, by putting the ball in play and using her speed of being a little bit more defensive and coming up with some good defense, she's able to work her way back into this match.
Looks like Wendy, too, has figured out maybe she isn't as good today at the net as she normally is, so she is going to stay back and hope that Annabelle, when she comes into the net, is a little bit less effective.
Yes, and Wendy's no dummy. She knows that you don't stay with a losing game, and coming in wasn't working, so she's staying back and just working her way slowly but surely into this match, and Annabelle's getting emotional. She's missing some shots, and she's starting to talk to herself.
Okay, thank you, Valerie. Game number 8 now, 4-3. Annabelle Croft is down in the second set.
That's a great shot.
And a powerful down-the-line forehand by Annabelle Croft puts Wendy Turnbull out of position, and she takes the early lead 15-love in this 8th game. Fine shot. Just out as Wendy Turnbull catches Annabelle Croft off her wheels for a second there. And Annabelle, just a little late to respond, scored 15-all. Now, Wendy's really changed her strategy.
She seems to be moving her feet more, and I think that's been a big factor. She's gotten, you know, maybe a little bit more confidence, but I think she just, you know, sort of woke up. It's just a totally different, you know, point or game or everything.
Came the match a little late today.
She forgot to change her clock.
And that shot is out by Wendy Turnbull, long. 30-15 the score. Annabelle Croft serving to even this match at 4-apiece.
Let first service.
So Annabelle Croft looking very much the player to contend with for not only this tournament, but the rest of the Virginia Slims year. And Wendy Turnbull, just an easy forehand tap over the corner there. We're back at 30-all.
Annabelle's having to move a lot more. And when she has to do that, she can't run around her backhand quite as much and try to, you know, catch Wendy off guard.
Annabelle Croft now serving at 30-all. Shot long by Wendy Turnbull to score at 40-30. Annabelle Croft serving for game number 8. And this will bring the match even in the second set to 4-apiece. Annabelle Croft, though, still having that very valuable first set victory. Oh. And a critical double fault error by Annabelle Croft. You wouldn't expect that at this point. It's at deuce. She had a chance to put the game away.
Yeah, I think she's just getting a little bit more emotional, just in not going out there and being as smooth and calm as she was before. She's realizing what the score is and who she's playing and what's going on.
And Wendy Turnbull's forgot who she was right there for a second. She just knocked that ball into the net like a rank amateur. Of course, she isn't that. A true top-flight championship world-class player. Ball just out, just missing the sideline. We're at deuce again, and Annabelle Croft doesn't seem to like that call too well.
It was awfully close, and you know, especially sometimes when she seems to see it hit, you know, she thinks that, you know, it went in. It seemed awfully close. I mean, the linesman probably has a better call on it.
Now, she has to be careful not to get caught up in this and start arguing and getting herself off track. Her major job out there is to make good shots and play this game.
Yeah, but it's, you know, when you're working so hard and you think you've hit a good shot, you can't just walk away from it if someone just calls it out. It's not, you know, it's so easy from up here to say, hey, she should hit this, or she should shut up, or she should do this, but it's not the same when you're on the court playing.
Okay, Annabelle Croft now, second service. Wendy Turnbull coming to the net.
Out!
Excellent net play, forces Annabelle Croft on a backhand error, and the advantage now to Wendy Turnbull, and she can take a lead in this set at 5-3 if she can put this point away. So a very important point for Wendy Turnbull. First service, Annabelle Croft. Advantage to Wendy Turnbull.
Out!
Now that serve looked like to me was in from up here, I don't know. But it was called out.
Now I think she's just gonna have to calm down.
Yeah.
That, especially in a serve, you can't tell.
Let's check that replay and notice where the ball hit Andrea. It looked like to me it was in.
Well, there we have her walking away. I couldn't quite tell on that replay.
Certainly close enough to upset you a little bit when it's called out.
Yeah, a serve like that and a big point is just, you know, it is a big factor. But if you miss your first serve and you keep on going at it, you know, it's different than if the point was over. The point isn't over yet. She has to come back with a serve.
Right, Annabelle's concentration is being challenged a little bit here. Pull herself back together. It's time to play. And they're serving it out. And now Wendy Turnbull has brought this set back to a 5-3. Wendy Turnbull has taken the lead 5-3. So a chance now to serve and win the second set. 6-6, she lost the first set. 5-3 now ahead. This whole match has changed dramatically with the two serves.
Yeah, I wonder how it looks down there. Val, does it look like that, you know, Annabelle's having a hard time getting her composure back?
Annabelle is really fighting herself right now. I feel that she wanted Wendy to agree with her. She got mad at Wendy because Wendy went with the lines person. And Wendy said, you don't never ask a player what the call was. I think Annabelle's immaturity is showing up right now, and maybe her lack of experience in a championship match.
Could really be a difference in this set altogether, huh?
Definitely.
Okay, so Wendy Turnbull trying to pull herself back together, win the second set. Annabelle Croft trying to get back on track. And a beautiful down-the-line forehand, running forehand that just pulled in Wendy way out of position. And Annabelle Croft has taken the early lead here. You see in replay that excellent shot.
And there she ran around her forehand again, and she came back, you know, and just, she has to try to do shots like that. She has to come back and, you know, get her confidence back together.
There, the backhand into the net, 30-15 the score. So Wendy Turnbull out in front in game number 9. Could be the deciding game of this set. If she can win it, she takes set number 2. 30-15. We've got all the excitement here for you from the Hilton Beach and Tennis Resort on Mission Bay, where Wendy Turnbull trying for a Virginia Slims title against Annabelle Croft. What a beautiful cross-court forehand that was on the run, and she just forced Wendy Turnbull into that error.
Yeah, here we've seen that Annabelle can go down the line with her forehand and run around and catch Wendy on the other side and, you know, go cross court. So that's why she's won a lot of her points.
And again, Annabelle Croft gets that ball position so that Wendy Turnbull's forced out of position, and the score now 30-40. And Annabelle Croft has a chance to break Wendy Turnbull's serve right here. To gain back that momentum she has lost. So Annabelle Croft would love to win this game right now. And with the game she has, Annabelle Croft has taken this ninth game. It's now 5-4 in favor of Wendy Turnbull, but Annabelle Croft is on the comeback.
Yeah, I think with all those calls, I mean, I think whenever you get a player out there and it's close and, you know, it's in the second set, that you're going to get a little uptight over the calls. And, you know, I don't know if that's immaturity. I think it's just, you know, getting wrapped up in the match. And you can't really expect anything more. At least she's out there, she's fighting, and, you know, she's going for every point, you know, not just letting anything go.
Okay, Valerie, 5-4. Wendy's come back. It looks like this second set might belong to her. She's changed her entire strategy. She's doing what you thought she should do. Andrea agreed that that was what she should do. If she keeps this kind of play up, is this going to confuse Annabelle Croft? It looked like Annabelle had the program figured out, but she doesn't look like she knows what's going on right now.
That last game, I thought that Annabelle got her composure back, and she got mad. And that's a good way to channel that energy that she was so upset. She's just channeled it into getting mad and fighting back. So I look for this a really tight game. I think Wendy is still tentative, and I think Annabelle now is on the charge again.
Are you surprised at Annabelle's foot speed? We talked about Wendy being very quick, but Annabelle's also excellent at her speed from the ball.
That's right. I'm very surprised. She's a large girl, and she looks very fit, but I didn't think she has so much power. I didn't think she'd be that quick, and she's been making some real good recoveries. On the other hand, I've seen Wendy be a real lazy with some footwork.
Yes. Okay, game number 10 now, and Annabelle Croft serving, trying to bring it back to 5-all. And that ball out, 15-love. So Annabelle Croft, the early leader, game number 10. 5-4, the second set.
There's a forehand cross-court volley again.
And just excellent position by Wendy at that point all the way through. She set Annabelle up for that.
Yeah, she kept on going back to her backhand because she knows she can't pass as well on her backhand as she can on the forehand.
Okay, 15-all, Annabelle Croft serving now. And with the second set, we see Annabelle Croft seriously lower her percentage of first services in. That's made a difference. And now another double fault, and we have a score 15-30 in favor of Wendy Turnbull. An important break here. She can break her and win 6-4, Andrea. Not only does she win the set, but she really sets herself up to win the third and deciding set.
Well, it'll help her if she starts to serve in the third set. I think Annabelle's getting a little tight, and you know, she's not worrying about, you know, just getting the ball on the court. She's trying to worry about what's going to happen in the next point or the next game or the match. She just has to take one point at a time.
Okay, the two players now exchanging baseline play. Both moving very quick and excellent ground strokes.
That was a great volley.
Annabelle Croft picked the right time to come to the net, caught Wendy Turnbull off guard, and picked up that point. Let's take a close look at this replay.
Here you can see Annabelle's been trying to move her around with her forehand shot, and you know, that's helped her throughout the match, and I think she's going to stick with it.
Okay, we missed that replay for you, but again, we can see Annabelle Croft moving excellently to the ball and pulling Wendy Turnbull off guard. Pulled her off again, and Wendy hits that forehand wide, and it's 40-30. Annabelle Croft has a chance here to take game number 10 and pull this match to even at 5 games apiece. Very important point. And that shot just in. Annabelle Croft has won game number 10. We are even at 5 games apiece, and convincingly, Annabelle Croft is coming back. Valerie, now Annabelle Croft picked everything back up again, gathered herself, her concentration looked great, her speed returned to her, she looked like she took control.
Yes, it definitely. That's what I thought would happen. She's raring to go, and I think Wendy is just hoping to hang in there. Okay. Totally defensive attitude.
Wendy Turnbull now serving in game number 11, set number 2. And that shot by Annabelle Croft, a beautiful cross-court backhand that just is inside the baseline enough. And she has the lead at love 15. And Wendy Turnbull shows the disappointment in herself over that.
Well, the first serve is going to be a big factor in this game.
I think it has been all the way down the line. Annabelle's been better at her first serve. Wendy has not. Annabelle Croft, another powerful cross-court backhand that catches Wendy off. Valerie, I don't think that Wendy has anticipated at all the excellent cross-court backhand that Annabelle Croft employs.
No, it's really hard to read with that top spin.
But coming into the match, Wendy thought that that was going to be her weakest point. It seems to be one of her stronger points.
Yes, she's playing very well today.
So Annabelle Croft, it's hard to pick out sometimes what the player's weak points are. She doesn't have any right now.
That ball did look out.
That ball was out, and love 40 now as Wendy Turnbull serving for a possible 6-5 disadvantage here. She's down by 3 points in this game.
Another first serve.
Another first serve against in the net. Just hasn't been there all day for her on that first serve.
No, it hasn't. Usually she wins a lot more points on her serve, and you know, here she hasn't.
And Annabelle Croft up powerful, runs around that down the line forehand and just puts away game number 11. It's now 6-5. Annabelle Croft is coming on strong. She's broken Wendy Turnbull.
Here is, you know, another one of Annabelle's forehand returns. Wendy isn't sure if she goes cross court or down the line because she winds up the same way. She stands the same way. And, you know, at the last second, she changes directions, and that's caught Wendy off guard throughout the whole match.
Valerie, with a player as young as Annabelle Croft is, to disguise herself that well against a champion like Wendy Turnbull, and for Wendy not to be able to pick up on it, we're dealing here with a player that's ahead of her age, really. She is an excellent player of the sport.
Annabelle is an excellent player, and as we all know, this game is so mental. All the youngsters coming up have a tremendous game. They can hit those ground strokes a ton. I'm very impressed with Annabelle's serve. I didn't know that she would have such a good serve.
Yes, she's had the greater percentage of first services in.
Right, and as far as, you know, so young, what is she now?
18.
That's not so young.
Probably the one most impressed. Go ahead.
I started to say she beat a 15-year-older last night.
Yes.
So we should talk about Wendy's age more than the youth of these kids.
Yeah, senior
that Wendy,
out there.
Yes, that Wendy's still doing so well at 33.
What's very impressive, though, is Annabelle's ability to regather her concentration and get back in the match. Okay, back now, game number 12, and an important one for Annabelle Croft as Wendy Turnbull puts away the first point, love 15.
I think Wendy's just going to go out and hit these balls and, you know, forget what the score is because she has to get back in there. She can't be tentative in, you know, a game where Annabelle's serving for it.
Yes. And really, Annabelle right now serving for the title. Just an excellent running cross-court forehand by Wendy Turnbull to score love 30. Now, Wendy Turnbull just simply has to win this game. It's over.
Yeah, she really doesn't have much of a choice.
So Annabelle Croft, with all the anticipation of being a champion on the Virginia Slim Circuit, running through her mind, Wendy Turnbull trying to survive right now.
She's just rushed a little bit too much in this game. You know, as the first, she didn't really get in her serves the way she did in previous games, and Wendy took advantage of that and, you know, has gone for forehand winners.
And Wendy coming to the net now, trying to put the pressure on Annabelle. And does so. And Wendy Turnbull has struck back and broken it. Annabelle Croft serve. We are now at 6-6 in set number 2. Well, this is a very exciting set, Andrea Yeager. The first set, 6-love, seemed very low in energy, lacking in intensity. All of a sudden, Wendy Turnbull has turned it around, and we're at 6-6.
Yeah, this is going to be great because, you know, neither one of the players have played that many tiebreakers this week, and, you know, it'll be interesting to see if Annabelle gets nervous or if she composes herself throughout the whole tiebreaker.
Okay, we are into the tiebreaker, and explain a little bit about the tiebreaker.
Well, the first point is served to the deuce court, and then all the rest of the points you start on the ad court, and it actually gets pretty confusing because then you have to switch after six, and it's, you know, you just have to keep your concentration throughout the whole tiebreaker. Before it was a 9-point tiebreaker, that you only had to get to five.
Now it's the first player to seven, but they have to get there and have a 2-point advantage on the other player.
Right, so you can keep on going, whereas a long time ago you had to play, you know, whoever had four all, the next point was it.
That was it. Serving Annabelle Croft in the net with that backhand. And the excitement grows here at this Virginia Slims of San Diego Championship. $75,000 in total prize money. $12,000 on the line in this match for first place. And Annabelle Croft is serving for the match in this tiebreaker. First player to seven wins it. Excellent off-speed forehand there to put it deep in the court. She hit it at her normal pace. It would have been out. So Wendy Turbo responded nicely.
Yeah, I think Annabelle's just a little bit nervous because you can tell she's not moving her feet as well in the tiebreaker as she did in the other games. And, you know, I think it's important also that, you know, neither player doesn't have anyone out there. Like Annabelle, if she had someone here she could look at that would give her reassurance, it might help her out a little bit now.
Well, she's got to be feeling the pressure, certainly. You've been there yourself. You know what it's like.
Yeah, it's nice to, you know, look over. I mean, when I was playing here, I looked over at my friend a couple of times, even though she knows nothing about tennis. And, you know, Annabelle, it just seems like she wants to look out at someone for her them to call the balls.
Annabelle Croft, a powerful cross-court forehand again, catches in Wendy Turnbull off guard. And the point total right now, the score.
Wendy's still up. She's up 3-2.
3-2, and Wendy Turnbull now serving for a 2-point advantage. And now the score at 4-1. Wendy Turnbull finds herself in a situation where she can grab a hold of set number two. She can get a couple of points here from Annabelle Croft's serve. She can really make it awful tough on her.
Sure, all she has to do is let me keep track of it. Annabelle's already run the tiebreaker.
1-5.
Now 5-1, Wendy Turnbull takes the lead out of this second set. So Annabelle Croft looking a little tired on that last shot, kind of a deep breath, relaxed attitude. She's got to get herself going right now. She's down by 5-1. We want to thank the fine producers. The producers, I'm sorry, would like to thank all of the people at U.S. Rentals for their assistance with the electrical lift that we're using today for one of our KUSI cameras. We certainly do thank U.S. Rentals. You've made it very easy for us to broadcast this event here from the Hilton Beach and Tennis Resort. And now at 5-2, Wendy Turnbull takes the serve and has a chance to win on these 2 points, this second set, if she can win these 2 points. At 5-2, she can take this match, or set, excuse me, at 7-2. So the excitement and the anticipation certainly is growing, and it looks tense in the stands as well as out there. That ball was called out, but from up here, I'll tell you something, Gander, that ball looked like it was in. It looked like it was right on the line, but it's out, and the score is now 5-3. So back comes Annabelle Croft from the jaws of defeat. Let's take a look at that and see how close that ball was. Certainly looked into me. What'd you think?
Well, from up here, I thought it was out, but looking at the TV replay, I think the lines just look a little thicker, and it could have, you know, it looks like it was in on the TV.
Okay. Back to the action, and Wendy Turnbull now. Desperately trying to put this set away. But no, she is now only ahead by 5 points to four in this tiebreaker. So now Annabelle Croft has a chance here on her next two serves to take the lead 6-5. But right now she has to win this next point to bring it back to 5-even. Oh, what pressure there must be on this young lady. And Wendy Turnbull moving around, trying to catch Annabelle off guard, does not. Annabelle comes up quick on that short shot and hits it deep into the sideline court, and for a point, a winner. You can see it again.
Here she is. She got up to that short ball really fast, and you know, there again was the forehand.
Five all. And Annabelle Croft with that excellent first service has now gone up to a 6-5 lead, can take this set and the championship. It's all on this serve by Wendy Turnbull.
I think everyone's talking about Annabelle having the pressure, maybe even the fans and stuff like that, but I mean, Wendy's the one who's ranked number 7. You know, she has everything to lose. Annabelle really has nothing. She's done well. If she lost 0-0, she's still in a good tournament. So Wendy really has everything to lose. I think she should be tighter than anyone else.
But right now, the whole match depends on what she can do right here. And in, and Annabelle Croft has taken this powerfully in the tiebreaker. She is the winner of this Virginia Sims San Diego tournament. The $12,000 first place prize, the handshake with the umpire Wendy Turnbull. A disappointed Wendy Turnbull has gone down a defeat to a very powerful young rookie player, this Annabelle Croft. Andrew Yeager, Annabelle Croft simply won this match today. She played better.
Yes. Yes, she did, especially at this point. I mean, this point, Wendy had a lot of chances. I mean, you see her, she goes for this one, and everybody's just staying there waiting to see where it's going. And, you know, it's nice to see Annabelle do well. I talked to her before a warm-up, and she was, like, so relaxed. I mean, I was asking her questions, and she was, like, so cool about it. But, you know, it's too bad for Wendy, but it was still a great match.
Okay. You folks stay with us. We're coming back right after this commercial break with more of the Virginia Slim San Diego Championship Tennis Match.
What's better than Ortho's low factory direct prices? Ortho's rare clearance sale prices. Selected twins, fulls, queens, kings. Now at unbelievable savings. Not just a few dollars. Act now and you'll save a bundle. Here's just one example, including the Ortho pack. Sheets, pillows, blanket, and bed frame. Only a selection like this can give you savings like this. Only during our clearance sale. Only for a limited time. Only at Ortho.
Welcome to Baskin-Robbins, where you can taste the glory of German chocolate cake, the delight of Cherry's Jubilee, the perkiness of Jamocha almond fudge. Whether you're after the ripeness of a very, very strawberry, the freshness of a chocolate mint, or in sherbet, or the indulgence of pralines and cream, whatever you're craving, wear your taste at Baskin-Robbins.
Aging, just as important to beer as it is to wine. Aging gives beer something called balance, just the right combination of flavors and aromas. Now, Coors thinks that aging is so important, they age their beer longer than any other major brewer. They use the time to age out a lot of the heaviness, a lot of the bitter aftertaste you'll find in many other beers. So when you want a beer that's a little smoother, but with all the spirit of a great beer, Coors is the one.
There's no shortage of import cars at Pacific Dotson. I'm Jerry Dineen, General Manager of Pacific Dotson, to tell you that Pacific has a very large supply of 82 and 83 Sentras, all specially priced and all in excellent condition. We have two doors, four doors, wagons, automatics, and standard transmissions, and a variety of colors. I suggest you act quickly. Why? Because they are all available with absolutely nothing down and payments of as little as $149 a month, only while they last and only at Pacific Dotson.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to thank you for all coming out today and making this Virginia Slims of San Diego a success. I'd like to introduce right now Mr. Bill Larimore from J. Roger Champagne, who's going to present the runner-ups award.
Thank you very much, Shane. Wendy? On behalf of J. Roger Champagne, congratulations. Thank you very much for a fine tournament.
And back now with you, we have James Stratton, lady that's going to be introducing and conducting the awards ceremony for you. And just had Wendy Turnbull with her second place finish check of $6,500.
I've certainly proved that you were the winner here. And I'd like to, on behalf of Philip Morris and Virginia Slims, I'd like to present you a check for $12,000.
Thank you
very much.
And now we see the happy champion, Annabelle Croft, out of
J. Roger Champagne, the hotel, the ball kids and the umpires, and especially the fans out there who are great. I'd also like to thank transportation for taking me to the movies every day before my matches. And Raquel and Jane for getting this tournament together. Thanks very much.
And Annabelle Croft, the fine champion, $12,000 richer, beautiful bouquet of flowers and some lovely champagne from the J. Roger people, represented by Bill Larimore and Mark Chapman. Want to thank those fine sponsors for hosting this championship. And this young lady receiving all the accolades that's due to her. Certainly Andrea Yeager, she earned the victory today. She played very well. She kept Wendy Turnbull off guard. She kept her off balance. She kept her really from playing her own game. You folks stay with us. We're going to come back with more of the Virginia Slims Tournament right after this commercial break.
Hot news! Alpha Beta's cooked up 30% savings on Stouffer's frozen entrees and side dishes, but only for 48 hours. This Monday and Tuesday, all Stouffer frozen food, including Lean Cuisine, is 30% off. Buy as many as you want with hot prices on dishes like macaroni and cheese, French bread deluxe pizza, and Lean Cuisine glazed chicken, but only Monday and Tuesday. So stock up on Stouffer's at Alpha Beta. Tell a friend, and you'll both warm up to the savings.
This week at Sun Valley Waterbeds have We Got Plans for You. We're 45 showrooms strong, which means our nationwide buying power saves you money with low monthly payments. For less than $14 a month, your choice of this elegant bookcase waterbed with oval-etched mirror or our popular Montrose sport poster for less than $14 a month. So this week, plan on extra savings and plan on low monthly payments at Sun Valley Waterbeds.
Stretch out on the Sun Valley Waterbeds.
You will sleep better.
Americans have a peculiar image of the Frenchman, wearing expensive clothes, surrounded by beautiful women, and sipping champagne. Not true, although I must admit I do enjoy my champagne. Thank you. It's J. Roger champagne. It's deliciously crisp, dry, and yet romantically subtle. It fits my simple lifestyle. J. Roger, perfect for a quiet night at home. J. Roger champagne, one of life's simple pleasures.
Attention, the Mad Jacks Red Tag Sale is going on now, and it's the largest sale in our history. All seven stores have marked down every receiver, every tape deck, every video recorder, every television, every car stereo, every system, everything and anything in stock, up to 50% off. Now is the time to buy. The Mad Jacks Red Tag Sale must end Tuesday. Take advantage of these prices that are absolutely our lowest. The Mad Jacks Red Tag Sale is going on now at all seven Mad Jacks.
Welcome back to the Hilton Beach and Tennis Resort, where we have the Virginia Slims Championship Final. You've just seen it. Wendy Turnbull going down a defeat and losing to the 18-year-old young rookie sensation out of Kent, England, Annabelle Croft. And I want to talk to Valerie Ziegenfuss for a moment. Valerie, you're down there on the court. It's obvious that Annabelle Croft played at her best today. It's also obvious that Wendy Turnbull did not play at her best, but doesn't that have something to do with Annabelle Croft's ability to keep her off balance all day today?
Oh, yes. Annabelle just played a superb... Yes, and Annabelle, you know, you have those days, maybe three times a year, where everything you hit is golden, and it seems to me that Annabelle had a match like that, and on the other hand, Wendy was not confident. She just had a bad day at the office.
Now, this is one of the situations where also the energy level, the concentration, tennis is much a mental as it is a physical sport, and anticipation seems to me to be very key in this sport. Annabelle anticipated Wendy very well. Wendy did not anticipate Annabelle very well.
That's true. As I said, I was really wondering, I didn't get to interview Wendy, but what her mental preparation was before this match, it seems to me maybe she didn't give it enough thought.
Okay, we thank you for your courtside comments. And now, as we prepare for the doubles championship final that's coming up, we want to take a slight opportunity here to thank Dick Van Dyke's Magic Comedy Hour, the 60 minutes of fun and magic for you kids of all ages. Tonight, you're going to